Well, like that, I'm done and I'm graduated. So recently I graduated university with a cybersecurity degree. I did it in 3.5 years. In today's video, I want to quickly talk about what the cybersecurity degree experience was like, where I'm headed, and the strategies I'm using to implement where I'm heading to. So yes, indeed, I'm graduated with a Bachelor's of Science in Cybersecurity at Southeast Missouri State University, which is located in Cape Girardeau, Missouri. So what was the cybersecurity degree experience like? Well, if you've been following me for the last 3.5 years, you will know maybe some of my lessons that I've learned throughout the process, including the wins and the losses and anything in between. Overall, to summarize my entire journey, the college experience was enjoyable both on a personal and professional development level. Personally, I grew a lot from a social perspective. Going into freshman year, I was a little different.
Hello everyone, my name is Grant Collins. I am an IT nerd.
So there was a lot of maturity there. Professionally, I was able to grow and establish my network while developing some of the necessary skills to get started in cybersecurity. So from a professional viewpoint, if you take a look at the college degree and experience at Southeast Missouri State, what I will say is that there were a lot of areas of development that the program needed to have to mature. There was a complete shift from practical application to complete theory throughout my 4 years. And so it went from being a really good program to one that had its shortcomings like anything, but it was one that really transitioned into more theoretical computer science base. It was interesting to see and witness that change. Luckily, I was grandfathered into the practical side of the industry, and that included a heavy focus on the networking side. I've done a video before outlining my cybersecurity degree, but to give you a brief overview of what it's like, I started out with my basic university studies, so that includes, you know, your math, history, and anything like those classes. What then you have to go into is some introduction to networking and some added layers of cybersecurity classes on top of that. And then once you get into your advanced level classes, junior and senior year, you're looking into more classes that are, of course, having more advanced topics in networking, network security, with the layers of cybersecurity classes on top of that. Every degree program is going to have their own curriculum, whether that's in the United States or anything internationally. Whereas if you take a look at a well-established degree, such as computer science, it's a little bit more concrete in what you will be learning. So what is next? I've finished my cybersecurity degree. In the process, I've gained 2 certifications, which are very entry level into the industry, the Security Plus and the AWS Cloud Architect Associate. So where is my career path going? Well, of course, as a young kid, I guess, you really don't have a lot of idea of where you're going. But I do have some general objectives that I would like to accomplish within the next 5 to 10 years. So the first thing that I want to get into is, of course, getting an entry-level job in cybersecurity. There isn't really one area of expertise that I have really focused on throughout my college years, which in a way has put me at a disadvantage. As a generalist or a jack of all trades, I'm open-minded to all areas of security. One particular area that has sparked an interest lately within the last 6 months has been cloud security. I think that this is an area that is going to continue to develop. So if there was an ideal position, I think that I would like to be exposed to the cloud security industry, but I don't necessarily have one particular interest in mind. I'm more of a generalist for the time being. Do I have a job lined up right now as a fresh cybersecurity graduate? Yes and no. I don't have anything officially signed. I am looking at opportunities, which I hope that one of them will line up. For the time being, I'm keeping it very general, but I am looking into the cybersecurity consulting side of the industry. I think that this will provide, for me personally, a good exposure to the different domains of cybersecurity, and I'm looking at junior or associate level positions as someone who, you know, doesn't have a ton of years experience in the industry, of course. So throughout the last 6 months, I have worked diligently on extending my opportunities as I've graduated here. I want to share just a few thoughts to keep in mind, some lessons that I've learned when it comes to getting a cybersecurity degree, certification, or just, you know, getting into the industry. The first one I think that is important is to leverage your network. You've probably heard of this before. Use the people that you know around you, and don't be ashamed in trying to reach out to a family member or a friend who is in the IT industry. It oftentimes helps you get your name out there, and maybe they won't help you directly, but they have a potential person who you could be introduced to. And I've been working on this strategy throughout the last 6 months more than anything else, trying to extend my opportunities through working with specific contacts within the area. The second strategy or idea, I guess, that I'm trying to apply is that I'm not chasing the six-figure or a high-paying salary for my first entry-level job. Rather, what I'm trying to work on is more exposure and experience into the different areas of cybersecurity. Now, of course, it depends on where you live and where you're at, but for me personally, I would rather work for a company or a position that I'm able to offer help into their organization, as well as having some more exposure and experience into the general industry itself. This is an idea that I'm trying to keep in mind because sometimes individuals like myself can get caught up in the chasing the highest starting salary, but I would rather build in more experience, especially in my earlier years. And, you know, if the salary compensates, decently well, a livable wage, then that's really what I'm just looking for the time being. Now, with this being said, let's talk about the experience or skills shortage gap. So as someone who has some background in cybersecurity degree, a few certifications, as well as a few internships, how can I wage that gap? What I'm trying to use throughout my application process is the different projects that I've worked on. What I try to do is I try to position those in ways to show that, you know, I'm just learning and that I have a deep level of interest or passion in cybersecurity to be an active and engaged learner. It's very general advice, but I've tried introducing personal projects that I've worked on, as well as talking about the lessons that I've learned throughout my class. Putting this in other words, what I am trying to do is wage the experience gap by showing that I'm an active learner, but I'm willing to develop and learn a whole new set of processes, policies, and the way things go about in an organization. As an entry-level worker, you are malleable. You are someone who can learn easily. You don't have any other past habits from companies that you take with you. So that is attractive to some extent as an entry-level worker because they can curate and develop you into the person that they deem fit in their organization. I know this video has been very broad overview of what the heck I'm doing. What I hope to detail in this video is that if you get a degree or certification, you know, in cybersecurity, it's going to take a holistic portfolio to get you started. And once you get your foot in the door, as they say, things can get easier, and you get your first level of experience. And that's the general career entry-level tips I'm keeping in mind. So getting into a cybersecurity career is not super easy, but it is doable. So like that, I'm done with my cybersecurity degree. I'm closing a chapter and opening a completely big and new one. And I hope to document it along the way. So hopefully you found this video useful to you in some way, shape, or form. And yes, until the next video, have a good day.